Today I want to talk about a topic that I never thought I was actually going to cover, but I thought it would be a really good topic to cover on the channel, mainly because I've been living in Florida now for a little over 12 years. And this entire time that I have lived here, I have noticed one thing about living here, and that is most of the businesses here are pretty unprofessional. And I'm talking a wide range of businesses. I'm gonna give you a few examples here. The ones I'm thinking of, like, are real estate agents like me. Well, I'm talking about handymen that come and do property repairs for you, like drywall, or they need to fix a leaky sink, toilet, something like that. Painters, people that clean. Those are the examples that come to my mind, but this runs across the board in many different businesses, actually. Not just those ones that I mentioned. The whole point of this video is to teach you how to start a successful business here in Florida. And I think this is going to be very encouraging for you, especially if you're from the north like me and you grew up in an area where people just do what they say they're going to do, because that is point number one that I'm going to make here. So many businesses and business owners here will make a bunch of promises that they just don't keep. And it's extremely unprofessional, and it's basically a tactic used by a lot of businesses to sell you on their service or their product, where they're basically overpromising and under-delivering. And I think that's just shady and wrong. And if you come from a northern state like I do, most likely you were taught that that was wrong. And if you are going to start your own business, that's probably the last thing you would do. You want to operate with integrity, because that's how you keep clients for a very long time. And that's what keeps your business running in good times and in bad times, by having a lot of repeat customers that come to you because they know that they can trust you and that you are a real, legitimate, reliable business. So the main points I want to hit on the most are being punctual, reliable, and professional. And you would be amazed, after living here for a while, seeing how many businesses don't have these three simple qualities. So my advice to you, if you're gonna be moving to Florida and you wanna start your own business, like I've seen a few of you mention in the comments, these are the top three traits that I think you must have to start a successful business here. Just by doing those three things alone, you're gonna put yourself ahead of 90% of the competition that's here. I guarantee it. And if you do that for enough people, then you're going to stand out very quickly in your industry. You're gonna be able to get some good testimonials and get some good client referrals from people that you've done right by, and that's going to help you succeed in your business very quickly. So that's how I recommend you start. I don't wanna get into a ton of the details of how to actually start the business, like getting the business license and all of the nitty-gritty details, because obviously, yes, you have to do that. And if enough of you ask me in the comments and you wanna see a step-by-step video tutorial on how to do something like that, then let me know. But that would be a pretty complicated video to make, because depending on the type of business you want to start, the steps will be different for everybody. So I don't think that's really appropriate to cover here. So that's why I'm kind of skipping that step and assuming that if you're going to be starting a business, then you already know how to get past those points and actually get up and running, okay? I'm talking more about what to do to run a successful business after you're already up and running. Let me give you some real life examples of how I have been wronged by some of these businesses here, so that way you can get an insight on what type of demand there is for professionals here. I have a unit that I manage for a client of mine, and that unit needed a new dishwasher installed. But before we installed a new dishwasher, the owner wanted to try to repair the dishwasher. So what did I do? I looked for a handyman or appliance repairman that could potentially come by, look at the dishwasher, and see if it could be repaired before we replaced it. And you wouldn't believe how hard it was just to get somebody there to do that. In fact, it was so hard that no one ever actually showed up to do this. Why? I have no idea. It seems like nobody wanted the job, maybe because it was too small of a job, I'm not really sure. But if that's the case, then businesses should just be honest, just like I'm honest. If somebody asks me to find an $800 rental for them here in Miami Beach, I'm just gonna tell them straight up that it's impossible, I can't find that for you. Good luck, you're gonna have to find it on your own. for two reasons. One, because it's almost impossible to find a rental like that, and also because it's not worth my time as a real estate agent. So by being that transparent with your clients, it might not be what everybody wants to hear, but you're going to look more professional by just being honest with your clients. And I think that also leads me directly into my next point about being professional. So much about being professional here is just so overlooked by so many businesses. And a few ways that you can be professional is, number one, being honest with your clients, like I have already said, but then also doing what you say you're gonna do. If you have a service or if you're selling a product, you better guarantee that that product will do what it says it's gonna do, or you're gonna be offering some type of a refund. Because if you're trying to just scam people out of money in the short term and you think you're gonna run a long-term sustainable business like that, you better think again, because people are gonna find out real quick that you're a con artist and you're gonna be out of business overnight. It's only gonna be a few months and you're gonna be done, trust me. The next thing is being punctual. You would also be amazed at how many people just don't show up on time and have zero respect for the other person's time, which is their potential customers, guys. I mean, these are people who you want to refer you business and call you again if they need you. And I don't call people again when they're a half an hour late with no legitimate excuse and just have no empathy towards the situation that I had to wait an extra half an hour for them to show up, or maybe even longer. And real estate agents here are also notorious for that. You'll set up an appointment with them and you'll be sitting in the lobby of a building waiting. 15 minutes go by. Oh, I'll be there in 5 minutes. And then another 15 minutes goes by. They're still not there. You've been waiting half an hour and they're still not there. This happens all the time and it's super unprofessional. And I honestly wish everybody that pulled this stunt would just go out of business, because that's what they deserve. If you can't live up to a simple expectation of just being on time, then you don't deserve to be in business. You should be out of business and you should be working at McDonald's, okay? Or whoever's going to put up with you showing up a half an hour late. Because me, being a professional, that's not something I accept, and I don't accept it from my colleagues, and I don't accept it from my clients, and I don't accept it from other businesses that I need to deal with. The last thing is being reliable. And what I mean by being reliable, I guess it's a combination of everything I just said. It's giving your customer or clients faith that when they call you, they know that the job is gonna get done correctly, and they know that it's gonna get done for a fair price, and they know that your work is going to be guaranteed. If your customers don't have that faith in you, then you don't have a business, in my opinion, because those things are what's going to sustain your business in the long run. I can't drive that point home enough. And here in Florida, it's just so laughable how unreliable everybody is. So in my opinion, guys, all you need to do to start a successful business here is just be on time, be reliable, and be professional, and you'll be ahead of just about everybody else here you're in business against. And you can probably run a very profitable business. And I would look directly into those businesses I mentioned, like look into being a real estate agent, look into starting a painting company, look into starting a handyman service, look into starting a tile company, something like that. A service that really needs to be done, that's never gonna go away. Even throughout the pandemic, all this stuff is still happening. All these things still need to get done. It's the perfect type of business to start down here in Florida, especially with so many new properties always being built and people with a lot of money renovating properties constantly. You're probably never gonna run out of work. I know that's not the kind of business that everybody wants to be in, but those are businesses that directly need a lot of help. And I think the competition is super weak. You can blow them out of the water, trust me. Now, before you go ahead and start that business down here in Florida, make sure to click on a couple more of my videos over here first and check those out. And I'll see you guys over there in that next video.